LS is short for list, and it's one of the most commonly used commands in Linux. You use it to list directory contents. Without any arguments, it'll display the insides of your current directory. If you give it a path, or even multiple paths, it'll list the contents of those. The command has a bunch of options that you can use to customize the output, but look, this is really basic and quite frankly boring. I was really on the fence about making this video at all, but then it hit me. And I can't believe I didn't think of this before, but I know now exactly what makes this so awesome. I'm really excited to share with you guys in this video. Welcome to Nick's Tricks. I am Nick, and this is LS. How's it going, guys? Hope you're ready for some action. Thought I'd switch it up a bit for this playlist, so we're gonna jump right in. Let's just look at the most popular options for now. We have -1 for one per line. This is typical standard vertical display. We got -a to include hidden items, the ones starting with a dot in Unix. We got -A to include hidden items but omit dot and dot dot, which is the current directory and the parent one. Then we got -l for long listing format. That's kind of like a table with ACLs on the left, number of hard links, owner, group, size, modified time, and the name of the item. We can use -g to hide the group, -o to hide the owner, -h for human readable file sizes, -S to sort by size, -r to reverse the sort order, there's -d to show directories but not their contents, and -R for recursive listing. Or if you prefer a cleaner output, I cannot help myself, you can use the tree command. -t to sort by time. By default, that's modified time. You can use this in combination with -u, printing and sorting by access time. With -c for see time. This is not to be confused with creation time. See time actually refers to the inode's change time. That's where the metadata about the file sits. One thing to note here, creation time or birth timestamp is not exactly a thing in the Unix world. Full support implies a file system that is able to store that metadata, an operating system that exposes access to it, and top-level software that actually uses it. I can tell you that it works on ext4, and that since kernel 4.11, which was released in 2021, we have access to system calls to statx, and the ls command can use it with the time flag. Depending on the version of your command, you may notice differences in these options. There are plenty of more others in the manual page for you to discover and experiment with. Normally, unless you're doing shell scripting or anything like that, you don't have to, since most distros nowadays provide a bunch of useful aliases for the ls command. In addition to that, you can of course always create your own aliases, and I have a cool video on that if you want to check it out. Now, this wouldn't be Nick's Tricks if it was all Nick's and no tricks, so I'm gonna share a couple of simple ones right off the top. First one, you can pipe the output of ls to the wc command, which stands for word count. That way you can get a count of items based on your filters. ls-1A pipe wcl to count all items. ls-1 pipe wcl to count visible items. You can do ls-1d */ to count all directories. If we wanted to see only the files, we would pipe the output of ls to grep and write a regular expression that says, hey, I want stuff that ends with an alphanumeric character, and I would have to escape that backslash. Last but not least, you can sort of find stuff with lsr, which goes through structures recursively. It's just useful to get some context, so that's why you pipe it to grep -C1. This may not all be the most popular and proper way to do stuff, but it sure does come in handy. So, you wanna know what I figured out? What makes ls awesome? It's subtle. I'm gonna show you something and ask you to keep an open mind. Think of it as a process. How do you navigate through a file system? When you use a file manager, Visual feedback is everything. I mean everything. You need to see the contents of a folder to be able to double-click the ones inside. Most graphical interfaces force you to do both operations in one. CD and LS, CD and LS over and over again. Go and see. The command line provides you with the option to just go and choose when to see. You can use the power of tab completion to guide your way and only see once you reach your destination. You save time by knowing when to use LS even if you navigate one directory at a time. As a matter of fact, you can perform virtually any file system operation without the need to ever navigate to your target. Just skip the entire navigation part, which is usually your only option in the graphical environment. I hope you found this video completely riveting. There's more of this to come in the following weeks. I'm hoping to grow the channel a little bit and that you can pick up some useful tips and tricks along the way before launching into bigger topics that I plan on covering in the future. Speaking of the future, if you're interested in this type of stuff and you want to be a part of it, you can do as little as to hit that like button or subscribe to get awesome new content weekly. Or you can do both. They are not mutually exclusive, those two. Feel free to check out my other videos, and if you see anything you like or know someone who might like it, share the love and drop a line in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.